Hello again, everyone. Well, I'm often asked what brought you through this journey and led you to work with hemp and to create hemp hooray. So I thought I'd answer a bit of those questions today in today's video. And I think in my life, it's very similar to what happens to a lot of people in their lives, where our journeys can twist and turn and get us to where we are today. And for me, I started out in menswear. I was a 2IC, second in charge, for 9 of 10 years in that store, and I loved it. I was young and it was fun and it got me through. But I guess I always knew there was something more that I would be doing eventually. And then I met my wonderful husband and we had our first son, Ethan. And when he was 2, we decided that we would go on an adventure, and we sold our home. We bought a 40-foot bus, and Simon spent 6 months decking it out. It was an amazing, amazing home, and we hit the road with the intention to travel all the way around Australia while Ethan was only 2. As it turned out, we spent 5 days on the road and ended up in a wonderful town called Kalgoorlie, Western Australia. And we spent 9 years there. We ended up selling the bus, buying a home. I had 2 more babies, our 2 beautiful daughters. And it was, again, a wonderful experience. But in those 9 years, I trained and got a diploma in aromatherapy. I did training in massage. And I worked from home around my young family in a little clinic that Simon built at the side of the house, and did relaxation, massage and Reiki and those sorts of things. But during that time, my love of hemp was expanded. I was using a lot of carrier oils and beautiful essential oils, and I used a lot of hemp with my treatments, hemp oil. And from there, I opened a store in Kalgoorlie called Aroma Cottage, and I sold a lot of aromatherapy supplies and also hemp clothing, hemp string, hemp bags, and a little bit of hemp skincare. And in the long hours of that store, in my spare time, I would mull over how I could create a product around hemp that could raise the profile somewhat more here in Australia for this amazing resource. And that's when Hemp Hooray was born. And around the same time, we had decided to come back to South Australia, where we're both from and our families are here. And we felt a long enough time away, and we wanted some different education for our children. We wrote strongly into Steiner education, Waldorf education for our children. And here in Mount Barker, they have one of the best Waldorf schools. So we've been blessed to be able to bring our children back here for that. So we packed up, came back to South Australia, and I have poured myself into building this business somewhat slowly in the first 4 years. We're in our 5th year now, and my children are at an age where I can devote much more time. So that's what I intend to do. And just as I said, use it as a platform to raise the profile of industrial hemp and what it can do. I've carried hemp with me most of my life. That may sound strange. I can't really pinpoint a time when this love of the potential of industrial hemp was born. Obviously, I read a book or I spoke to someone, but I've carried it with me from a young age and always had an interest in environmental issues. But I just see hemp as a huge potential. I would love to see our farmers here in South Australia obtaining licenses and growing hemp as a rotational crop. It can do so much to add income, to add health to their soil, and potentially supply me with some hemp oil for our wonderful products. And there's amazing things being done in the industry here in Australia, but obviously there's much more that can be done. And as many of you may know, the recent lobbying, we have the application in for hemp foods here in Australia, and once that is accepted, which we should know in around August, or we should know more, I believe it will be passed. I think the time has come, and that's a really exciting thing, because every Australian has the right to proper health and nutrition, and the hemp foods industry can blossom and flourish and provide that service to the consumers of Australia. So that's really exciting. And there's other people along the east coast in Tasmania doing wonderful things in the hemp industry, and I'm really proud to know of them and work with many of them. So yeah, that's briefly my journey. It's been an exciting one, a challenging one. There are many issues with starting your own business, but the biggest thing is the satisfaction to the soul, and you know, as challenging as it can be, it's a blessing to be able to work in an industry that's worth fighting for, and I really believe that the hemp industry is certainly that, and it could do many, many wonderful things. So that's a little brief introduction to my journey and how I came to Hemp Hooray and the passion I have for this amazing resource, and I hope you share the same passion and we can really raise up this profile and get wonderful things continuing to happen for hemp and for the planet. So once again, thank you for your time, and until next time, take care. Bye for now.